following single shot cameos are of regular and special scubas who are identified by subtitles. They were a pleasure to have aboard. As long as we don't exhale, there are no bubbles to spook the fish. Part of the purpose of this shot was to actually be in position when the fish did scoot. There. Toe sub is a regular feature of each day's video shoots. We use it for maneuvering here and there and for lugging gear back and forth to any particular site. There are some things we see for the first time, even though we've plied these waters for nearly 60 years. He, and he is a male, could be digging for a clam. Bear in mind, with his eyes on the top of his head, he really can't see much of what he's doing. He might be trying to hide, and that would seem to be a daunting task. There might be a female in the whereabouts, but that wouldn't seem to explain this interesting behavior. A pair of fins marks this spot, where many scuba divers congregate. The easy entry and protected waters are ideal for divers of all experience levels. Anywhere we can lay our gear down is called home. Our friendly float and flag heralds divers in the water, at the surface and under the surface. In these clear waters, Chris swims up a draw and makes her way into a region of small valleys and startles an innocent flounder in the process. Chris crosses to the other side on her easy trek. Up ahead is a unique bottom marking. The view from mid-distance in this clear water looks more than just interesting. A closer look now invites a cautious pointing finger, and the shape is disclosed in an explosive move. With a wary-eyed stare, the ray decides this place ain't big enough for both of us. We also get into Cape Ann's waters, entering from boats. Descending from above, boiled in cascading bubbles, we never know what we'll drop in on. This is the largest horseshoe crab that the captain has ever seen. According to our resident authority in these matters, it's a female. No wonder the little guy in the previous shot was digging. Laurent sent the lady on her way, and she literally galloped away. This animal is the only one of its kind in American waters and cannot be confused with anything else. It feeds on clams and worms. In spring, they congregate near shore. The female lays up to 250 pale greenish eggs. The eggs are buried in the sand, where they lie for several weeks until hatching as miniature horseshoe crabs with tiny button tails. On a clear day, we can practically see forever. Moving along the canyon and coming up from a deeper spot, Chris encounters a shy crab, maneuvering to stay hidden, he thinks. When they're behind seaweeds, they think they're invisible. You would wonder what spooks crabs. Generally, they're hunkered down, but sometimes they're quite acrobatic. That one might have been dozing in the daylight. Moving close to the bottom, Chris can see places where fish congregate and mill about. By careful camera positioning, she will be able to record an interesting happening. The first time we saw this being done, Peter was tapping his lobster probe against a rock, and oddly enough, he attracted a ton of fish. Chris has tried several tapping items, a mallet, a screwdriver, to mention just two. What seems to work best so far is a hand-sized rock tapped against the bottom. What brings them out is a puzzle. What scurries them off is no puzzle. The sight and sound of exhaust bubbles sends them flying away. Perhaps they have short memories, because back they come. Kerry Hurd, an Emmy Award winner with his wife Linda, is a regular on Easy Diver. He is readily recognizable by the knee pads he wears to protect his dry suit. He is climbing into the background to bring images of his quarry to the foreground for us to see. This lobster was determined not to be a keeper, and in the lobster's mind, neither was Kerry. Good for Kerry, eh? We have judged this lobster to be 40 years old. Al Frazoco, with his daughter Candace and her fiance, Will, regular divers on Easy Diver, redirect themselves across the bottom to watch Chris, who is intent on yet another subject. Al, with his real and extended family, has been diving with us for 25 years. Some things are better approached cautiously, especially when they're big, and especially when they don't seem inclined to move away right away. intently still, covered in a coating of sand, with both wary eyes on Chris, the ray must be deciding, can I get a meal out of this one? It had lain where it was long enough for several small mobile crabs to have left tracks in its sand camouflage. The crabs were joined by a daring olive snail, who was sizing up the situation as well. Brave little critters, eh? Out on the plain, an excavating lobster has its attention momentarily interrupted. Faced with a bubbling intruder, who is obviously bigger than it is, the smart move is to evacuate. This one is far, far away from a safe hole under a rock into which to stuff itself. So, out in the open, it retreats across the bottom, never taking his eyes off us. Chris directs the other cameraman to set up for a two-shot sequence. Watch the subtle body moves that this lobster makes as it rearranges itself and its root in the course of being wrangled by Chris and the captain. Pure Fred Astaire. Is it a tango, a bolero, or just a good old two-step? Our general impression of lobsters is that they hole up in rocky terrain. Although they are hermit-like animals, at times they do venture out onto the sandy plains to forage for small critters. This guy has a mantle of sand on his carapace. Look at him dance and pirouette. The lobster has pranced and danced. He's done turns. His dance card is full, and yet there's no let up here. Escaping as fast as he can, he holds his claws high and literally races away. We're learning a lot about lobsters today. Watch these bigger guys come out to the tapping over time. Although still slightly skittish, they become more emboldened despite Chris's exhale bubbles. Anyone with any ideas as to why this works, we're all ears. Now, in 35 years of boat diving Cape Ann, we've seen a lot of interesting things. Chris found this curious situation. Here's the shank of an anchor, wrapped in an abandoned chain, and, as you'll see, broken off at the other end. Sitting on top of all of this debris is a hermit crab. High up the pole, he's safe from his enemies. Hermit crabs are more sure-footed than earlier imagined. You will see this crab leap. Watch. Now on Chris's hand, it scurries all about. The timekeeper checks the gauge and signals, we're out of here. Laurent ascends to easy diver. It's the same beautiful topside day. Are they gone? Looks like the coast is clear. Better get back. I wonder how they left things. I wonder where my boyfriend is.